everybody. Happy Friday. Although today's not really Friday. Today's actually Thursday night. But I'm not really feeling well this week. So I don't think I'm up for making the video tomorrow. So I'm going to make it tonight while I have a little bit of energy. I'm going to start to do this video really fast because I don't know how long I have. First things first, we're going to have a drink because I am getting drunk all by my lonesome. Okay, let's try to do this quickly. I have a lot to say. Monday I went to go see Paranormal Activity 3. I went to the movies all by myself because my husband and I haven't been talking. And so, it sucks on my part. I don't like anyone mad at me. I don't like tension in the house. And so, he's basically wasn't talking to me because I rejected him. Because he's in love with me and he wants to have sex with me and he wants to do all these things. And I fucking don't want none of that. And so, it was really tense in the house and I couldn't stand it until I had to get out. I went to Starbucks actually in the afternoon. Well, actually in the morning time. And I took my laptop and I took advantage of the free Wi-Fi and the overpriced cappuccinos, which were good, by the way. It was nice. It was nice to reread everything that I had written. And just sit there with the laptop and kind of just get away and feel like an adult, you know? God, I really have that. Then I went to the movies because I didn't want to go back home. Everyone told me Paranormal Activity 3 was going to suck. Including the boy. The boy's like, baby, please don't go see the movie. I beg of you. If you go see that movie, I think I'm going to have to reimburse you for what you spent because you're going to regret it. Because he saw that movie already. And like I've said before, he doesn't really, he's not like a bad movie critic. Like, he watches whatever. But he said that this one particularly sucked big time. So that's why he wanted to spare me the horrible movie experience. So, but I went ahead and went to go see it anyways. The movie sucked big time. It sucked big cock. I like the first one. I know people are like, oh, I hate Paranormal Activity Part 1 or whatever. Or in general, all of them. What is wrong with you people? I like the first one. I did. It scared the shit out of me. I didn't sleep that night. I slept with the lamp on. You know why it scared me so much? Because my childhood was really bad. Because I grew up with parents that were freaks. Like my dad and my mom. I grew up in the religion of Santeria and Brujeria. For those of you that don't know what that is, it's like they sacrifice animals and they believe in ghosts and they believe in, they talk to ghosts and they believe in saints and, my God, it's like a big old scrambled eggs of fucking horror. So that was my childhood. My mother, oh my God, I cannot stress how bad my childhood was. My mom would get drunk and come to my room and wake me up and tell me stories, and not bedtime stories like, oh, cute little shit. No, she would tell me ghost stories. And ghost stories to her were actual reality of her childhood. Like, her sister died when she was really, really young. And so she would tell me, like, her sister would come in the bed and sit down on her bed and, like, visit her and all this shit. And so, my God. Yeah, those were my bedtime stories. My mother used to torture the shit out of me. So, I scare easily, okay? Especially when it comes to, like, I don't really get scared, like, if a fucking man with a hockey mask comes and, like, kills everybody, or Freddy comes and kills you in your dreams and shit. No, stuff like that doesn't scare me. What scares me is ghosts. Ghost stuff and, like, dead people shit, that scares the fuck out of me because I grew up with that and that was not fiction to me. That was, like, fucking reality to me. So, that's why it scares easily. But anyways, regardless of that, Paranormal Activity 3 sucked balls because I think they copped out on the plot line. Paranormal Activity 1 was interesting to me because you were kind of really curious as to know what was plaguing this woman and what was this thing after her. But as Paranormal Activity 2, I don't remember. Honestly, I don't. I have to watch it again to fucking see what the fuck it was about, because I don't remember. This one really pissed me off because, like, I think they chose, like, the stupidest explanation to, like, explain everything. It just pissed me off. So, I think the highlight of my movie experience Monday, Paranormal Activity 3, was all of the overpriced fucking food that I ate at the movie theater. I'm sorry, just a second. So, sorry. Yeah, that was the highlight of my day. All the overexpensive pizza and popcorn and candy that I ate at the damn theater. My God. Oh, God. I ate pizza and popcorn, folks. And then I had to go purge in the woman's bathroom. The woman's handicapped bathroom, no less. Thank God that the movie sucked, so it wasn't a lot of people watching the movie. And also, it was the afternoon when I saw it, so I didn't have a lot of people to worry about hearing me throw up. But it was a hard purge nonetheless, because I ate things that began with the letter P. And what happens when I eat things that begin with the letter P? They try to kill me. So I ate pizza and popcorn, and the pizza and popcorn were kind of like, you know, wrestling, where the things kind of slap each other on the wrist and they do like a tag team. They're like, okay, now it's your turn. Yeah, they did that. They both kind of tag team my ass and took turns trying to kill me. But I got the majority of it out. So Tuesday, we finally, my husband and I, started talking. I called in on my shrink and I canceled my appointment. Why did I cancel my appointment? Because I don't like my shrink, folks. I miss my old shrink a lot. I miss her terribly. I never thought that me not seeing her would affect me so bad. Like, I'm doing bad. And I think it all stemmed from the fact that I couldn't see her anymore. I am doing really bad with my eating disorder this week. But I miss my old shrink terribly. My old shrink was very supportive of me. My old shrink was older than me, so she had a lot of life experience. I would tell her something about my life, and she would counteract with something about her life. She didn't have to. She didn't have to get personal with me, but she did. And I miss her terribly. She was so supportive of me. I had little milestones. I had little victories, whether it be standing up to my husband, whether it be feeling good that day about myself, self-esteem-wise, or talking about something good that happened in my day, she would always be so supportive of me. And God, I miss that so much. And she went above and beyond for me on numerous occasions. I don't know, I really looked up to her. And I felt like, I don't know, I saw her kind of like a mom figure almost. And I, like I've said before, I can't stress enough how much of a bad childhood I had. I, like a lot of people say, I have daddy issues. I don't have that. My dad was the epitome of what a man should be. My mom, on the other hand, I have mommy issues. My mom was very abusive. And so my shrink felt like a mom to me. She just felt very protective and sheltering and encouraging and supportive and very loving. And you know, I would think like, wow, I want, that's how a mom should be, you know? So, I just really miss her to death. I used to look forward, like I couldn't wait for Tuesday to come. Talk about Happy Tuesday. I could not wait for her to come so I could see her. Now this other shrink, I don't feel like that. I don't trust her. I feel as though I'm a job to her. She doesn't support me. She doesn't encourage me. I called in on her because I didn't want to go and hear about, like I'm going through shit and I don't want to tell her, and then she tells me, you know, this is what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to do this instead. Yeah, okay, this and that, but this is what you're supposed to do. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear what I'm supposed to do. Obviously, what I do is not the right way, you know, because I'm not really 100%. But I don't want to hear how bad my mistake was or how bad my choice was. I want to hear, you know, something, you didn't do what you're supposed to do, but regardless, you did better than what you did last time. I need to hear that. I don't need to hear about what I didn't do. I need to hear about the 50 other fucking choices, bad choices that I didn't make. That's what I need to hear about. And she's not like that. She's not encouraging at all. And I don't trust her. I also don't trust her. And I don't, I think there's an animosity between us because, because she's 4 years older than me. And so I feel like, she doesn't really have much to bring to the table. And I also feel like she tries too hard. She is trying to be by the book too much. And trying to be like the perfect psychiatrist and shit. And my god. I just honestly don't trust her. And you know what's fucked up about the whole thing? Is that with my old shrink, I was ready to tell her about my eating disorder. I was getting ready, you know. I was like working up to telling her. And so with this shrink, I don't trust her enough to tell her about my eating disorder. And I really want to talk about my eating disorder because I'm like, my god, I'm getting so fed up with the thing. I'm just so tired of it. So it just sucks. So I canceled on her ass. She makes me want to quit the therapy process altogether. I swear to God, I feel like I don't want to do it anymore. But I need to because I really need someone to talk to about things. I have no one, you know? I don't have anyone who understands. So, I came home. Oh, well, I didn't come home. Well, actually, I did come home because I went to Walmart on Tuesday. And I bought, like, stuff to eat for the house. And then I bought 6 bags of candy, like, Halloween candy. Because they were all on sale. They were 75% off. So they were, like, $1 or something each. And then when I came home, I got something in the mail. I got a nice, pretty envelope with, like, a bunch of cats on it. And so this is what I got in the mail. I got a bracelet from the lovely blogger, Jen. Her blog is Cat Tales, and the new blog, and so I put the link. I'm sorry, sweetie, if I don't remember the name. I had a lot to drink tonight, but I want to say thank you for my bracelet. I put it as tight as I could. I know it's a little bit it's a little bit low. It's not as low as this one, but you know, it's on there. I put it as tight as it's not going anywhere. I want to say thank you for my bracelet. I love it. I love the colors. It fits nice. I love that you made it. And I love that the consideration and the thoughtfulness that went behind it. I love whenever anyone takes time out their day to think about someone else. Whether it be a phone call, a letter, opening the door, taking out their trash, asking how they're doing. I love whenever another human being takes time out of their day to think about someone else and not even expect anything in return. That makes my day. That makes me smile. And so I want to thank God bless you and thank you for sending me my bracelet. And it's really sweet and I love it. I got home. I got on the computer. I started talking to the boy. My God, the boy. I was telling him about the candy. I was like, listen, I got these candies, like 6 bags of candy or whatever. And so he loves candy, like I love candy. And so he was just like, oh my God, I'm so jealous because the candy's not on sale over there. It is, but it's not $1. So he was just like, oh my God, I'm so jealous. So I told him, I'm like, listen, I'm gonna take, when I head up there, I'm gonna take 3 bags of candy for us. He got so happy. So yeah, we are gonna be in the bed a lot. I think we're not gonna leave that bed all day, so might as well have some food while we're there. Candy. Might as well have some sugar. We're gonna need the energy. Well, actually, I'm gonna need the energy because he's 22. He doesn't need any kind of energy at all. He is, his libido is really well. So I think I'm the one gonna need sugar and Red Bull and fucking coffee and all kind of shit. 5-hour energy drink, all that shit I'm gonna need to keep up with him. So, especially since we haven't seen each other, we constantly are talking, so my God, but he is so excited. My husband started talking to me Tuesday, so we're getting along. It's less stress. I'm really struggling, guys, with my eating disorder because, oh God, my eating disorder is just so loud, and it's just telling me how much I suck because. I am 110 pounds and I want to be less than 110 pounds. I want to be, to be honest, I want to be double digits. I want to be like fucking 90 pounds. So I am not. And so because I am not that amount of weight, I feel like a failure. I feel like shit. And it's all the eating disorder, you know? It's really, really messing with me. It's messing my perception. I didn't take my medication today at all. Depression, anxiety, at all. Vitamins, nothing. Instead, I took a diet pill. I have been taking laxative and diet pills. I have been taking water pills. I have been indulging in the eating disorder, doing whatever it wants, doing whatever it demands. And it always wants more and more and more. And I can't keep up with it. I have been drinking a lot. I want to drink every night if I could. Drinking plus medication have been knocking me out. I would get drunk before, but now I'm really getting really, really drunk. Really fucked up because, you know, the pills and the alcohol, you know, so. It's not good. I am really anxious all the time. I am just really worried. God, I'm worried about Thanksgiving. I'm worried about cooking, eating, gaining weight. I'm worried about the boy. Oh my God, the boy. I'm worried about him. I hate the way I look. I hate my body. I think I'm just this horrible, fat, ugly monster. And so I worry about gonna go see the boy and him seeing what I see, you know, him taking a look at me and agreeing with what I see in the mirror. And so I know it's all bullshit, but I can't help but feel like that because I just cannot stand the sight of me. So but he doesn't feel like that. I have to keep telling myself that he God, this boy. He tells me all the time how much he cares about me. He tells me all the time. He's like, my God, I really like you. I think about us together. I want us to be a couple. I wish you could live with me. I miss you. I wish you were here. You are so beautiful. You are so sexy. He tells me, I think about you all the time. You make me so happy. Like, he just tells me all the time how he feels. And I love that. I need to hear that. Because I'm insecure, you know. And I know it's stupid. And I shouldn't feel like that, but I do because of the fucking eating disorder. So the fact that he says those things, I'm trying to look into that and like believe it, you know? But it's hard because the eating disorder wants me to think otherwise, you know? It wants me at my lowest. It wants me to not want to be with anyone else but it, and not have friends or loved ones or family or relationships, you know? It just wants me to just indulge in the behaviors all day and that's it. Until I'm dead, you know? I've been so down today to the point where I've been thinking about completely sabotaging when I go to see my sister. Like, not with my sister, because my sister knows about my eating disorder. I mean, she has her own to worry about. Oh, which I hate, because I feel responsible for that, because I told her about my own eating disorder. Like, I lost all this weight, right? And she thought I was doing it because I exercised and I ate right and all this shit. And then when I told her about my own eating disorder, she kind of was like, wow, you had me thinking it was this and it was the other thing. And so now she kind of is doing the same thing I'm doing. Like, she's already lost like almost 50 pounds. Kind of doing what I've used to do. And so I feel like if I would have never told her about my eating disorder, then she wouldn't have had her own eating disorder. So I have guilt with that, because I feel, you know, I feel like shit and I am killing myself. So now I feel like I'm killing her too, you know? So I have guilt. Although she is a grown woman and she's making her own choices, but I just can't help but feel like that. But anyways, so now I'm riddled with guilt for the eating disorder, for my husband. I am going to see my family. He doesn't have family. I am his everything. I feel guilty because I am everything to him, and I don't want to be his everything. And I feel bad because he doesn't have anybody on Thanksgiving, but I can't really do anything about that. I have to think about me. I feel bad because of my sister, her own eating disorder. Although I know when I go up there, I can binge and purge around her because she's doing the same thing. That's not a problem. But I am worried about the boy because I cannot not eat around him, because he doesn't like when I don't eat. He tells me, have you ate today? Did you eat today? And I'm like, yeah, I did. And then he asked me, and it's like this big debate or whatever. So he and I are going to be together all the time, and so I'm worried about not eating around him. And so, God, I don't want to talk about the elephant in the room. So I'm just riddled with guilt, because I'm worried about a bunch of shit, and the eating disorder is fucking with me because it wants me to isolate myself. It wants me to sabotage everything. It wants me to ruin things with the boy and give up on relationships with other people, especially with men. It wants me to not invest feelings in anyone else. It wants me to be by myself, to give up the idea of being loved and someone caring about me, loving me, and me being happy and being normal. It wants me to stop all of that shit. So I sincerely thought about it today. But you know something, folks? I'm not gonna listen. You know why I'm not gonna listen? Because I wanna fucking fall in love again. I wanna love someone. I want someone to love me. I have so much in my heart that I wanna give to someone else. And I'm not gonna let anything or anyone stop me. I am looking forward to being incredibly, stupidly in love with someone, to being reckless and spontaneous and just giving someone everything that I have. Giving someone the good that I have in me. I want to make someone feel good. I want to make someone feel special. And I'm not going to listen to the eating disorder. It could go fuck off. So yeah. But I've been struggling. I'm going to try my best to not listen. And I'm going to try to slow down these behaviors, because they are making me feel sick. They're fucking up my workout. I feel weak. I am slacking off on working out, and I haven't been eating because eating makes my stomach hurt, makes me sick, and unless it's something liquid, God, it so bothers me, so yeah. But that's it, I think I'm gonna go because I have no idea how long this video is, and I'm sure it's like a half an hour already, so. I will talk to you guys again on Saturday. I'm gonna write down whatever else I need to talk about. I hope you all are well. Thank you for listening to all my bullshit. Oh, God. I will see you all again on Saturday. So, good night and goodbye.